So, let us start today's class on 11th February 2021. Today, my dear students, we want to study about isomerism. In the 10th class also, you have studied about isomerism. So, can any of you tell me what is isomerism? What is isomerism? When two substances have same structural formula, same molecular formula, but different structure or structural formula, both these substances are called isomers of each other, and the phenomena of having isomers is called isomerism. So, this is how, my dear students, we can understand about the isomers and isomerism. The same definition you have also studied into the 10th standard, but still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. There are various types of isomerism, my dear students, we have in our syllabus. So we'll study them one by one. Okay. Do you have anything to ask into this, or we should move forward?
No, sir.
Okay, so now let us study about the types of isomerism. So first we should study about the various types of isomerism. Let's first see, we want to study about isomerism. And there are various types of isomerism. So the major two types, we can say they are known as the structural isomerism and then, my dear students, we have stereoisomerism. Now, this structural isomerism is also of various kind, my dear students. So, this structural isomerism can be the first one, like chain isomerism. Then we have position isomerism. Then we'll functional group isomerism. And then, my dear students, we have metamerism. And in stereoisomerism, dear students, we have geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. So this is how we study about them. So these are the various types of isomerism, my dear students. We are going to study this type of isomerism in detail now. So let's move forward and understand each type of isomerism. First, let us have a look to the isomerism, that is what it is known as the chain isomerism. Chain isomerism. It is a type of isomerism that has different, that shows the different carbon chain, my dear students. So let me explain you this with few example. Suppose you have a compound with 5 carbon. So according to the alkane, it should have the molecular formula CnH2n+2, that will give us C5H2 5s 10 plus 2 12. This is what it is, the compound that we have. Now we can arrange the 5 carbons in a various ways. So let me show you how we can arrange this 5 carbon. First arrangement is this, that we arrange all this carbon into the straight line. We may arrange them in this way. And then we can have a carbon over here. Or we may arrange them in this way. And then we put the hydrogen. See, this is CH3, this is CH3. Here you have CH2. Now if you count the number of hydrogen, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 3, 12. So it goes 12. Same way if you put CH3 this way, then you have CH2, and then here you have only CH. So you can now count the number of hydrogen, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 3, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 1, 12. So here even we have 12 hydrogen, here CH3, 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 and CH3. So this is how, again, you can have the 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, that is 12 hydrogen. Now, if you have any question, I think someone has raised the hand. Do you want to ask something, Ashish? Okay. So this compound, if we write the IUPAC name, my dear students, for these various compounds, we can write the IUPAC name. For this compound, we can write pentane. For this compound, we can write it as a 2-methylbutane. And for this compound, we can write 2,2-dimethylpropane. This is how we can write it. But if you write the general or trivial name, my dear students, we can have the various names that we can write. For this, my dear students, we can write normal pentane. Please remember, my dear students, that for this we can write normal pentane. This N represents normal. For this, my dear students, we can write isopentane. And for this, my dear students, we write neopentane. So with the black pen, we have written the general or common names. And this is how, my dear students, we can write the various types of names. Here you can easily identify that these are the IUPAC names and these are the common names. So again, we can classify these types of compounds into the other classes. For example, this is a linear compound. This is branched. And this is highly branched, we can say. But if you see that their structures are different, but they have the same molecular formula, and this kind of compounds or these. So we can easily say that normal pentane isopentane and neopentane are called structural isomers, sorry, chain isomers of each other. Are called the chain isomers of each other. So I hope, my dear students, now you understand about the chain isomers. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Bachcho, chain isomers.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, okay, good. Now, let us see some important thing about this chain isomerism. See, chain isomers they are linear, they are branched. When the chain isomers are linear, they have generally high melting point or boiling point. And compared to linear, the branched isomers will have low melting point or boiling point. Now, what is the reason? How can we explain this reason? So, for linear chain isomers, there is more surface area. But for branch isomers. You know the shape slowly or as the branching increases, the shape slowly turns to be spherical. As branches or branching increases, thus branched isomers have low or less, comparatively less surface area. Thus what happens that due to the less surface area, see the van der Waals forces, directly proportional to the surface area, and therefore melting point or boiling point of linear chain isomers high as compared to branched isomers. My dear students, please mind well, please try to recall that we have studied into the previous standard that, you know, the spherical shape has the lowest surface area. So my dear students, what happens here that if you have a linear carbon chain, then you will realize that the surface area is more. If you have branched, then you will realize that, you know, the shape is little going to be spherical. But if the branching increases, my dear students, you will find that the surface is going to be more spherical. So as the branches increases, dear students, as branching increases, surface area decreases. Because as the branching increases, the shape goes more and more spherical. And linear shape has a comparatively more surface area than the spherical shape. So if we compare the surface area, we would realize that the surface area of linear shape is more than the surface area of spherical shape, and that is why the branched, this is highly branched, and that is why the branched isomers will have lower surface area as compared to the linear isomers. And we know that the van der Waals forces, or which are responsible for the melting point and boiling point, so we can say that van der Waals forces in linear We can even write it one to one. Forces, if we compare the van der Waal forces, what we can say that linear shape is generally more van der Waal forces than the spherical shape, and that is why we can say that the melting and boiling points of linear isomer is greater than the branched isomers. So this is how, my dear students, I hope you understand. If still you have any doubt, you can ask me. Bachcho kuch puchna hai to puch sakte hain aap log. Kuch puchna chahenge? Would you like to ask anything? Please reply. Hello, dear students, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
So, do you have any doubt, or should we move forward?
No. No doubt, sir.
Okay. Now, my dear students, we want to study about the position isomerism. Let us study the position isomerism. So let us understand what is position isomerism. So when two isomers differs by the position of branch or less prior functional group, they are called position isomers. Let me explain this with some of the example, my dear students, so that you can understand it well. Suppose you have CH3CH, CH2CH2, CH3, and then you have CH3. Same way you may have this CH3CH2CH, CH2CH3, and then CH3. So if you find out the molecular formula, you will find that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 carbon. And if you find out the number of hydrogen, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 1, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 3, 14. Same way, if you do the same here, you can have 6 carbon and hydrogen, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 3, 8 plus 1, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 3, 14. So both have the molecular formula C6H14. But if we start giving numbering, my dear students, you would realize that here we can easily write that this is 2-methyl pentane. I'm sorry. This is 2-methyl pentane. Whereas this is 3-methyl pentane. So both of these are known as the position isomers of each other. Both these are known as the position isomers of each other. So this is how, my dear students, we study about the position isomers. Let me explain this with few more examples. Suppose you have CH3CH, double bond CH, CH3. Or you may have CH2 double bond CH, CH2 CH3. So what you find here in this case is that you have C4 and it is an alkene, so H8. Let us count 8, 3 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 3, 8. Here also you can see that 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 3, 8. So this is how, my dear students, we can have C4H8. But if we give the name, my dear students, we realize that the names we can give them as this one, let's say it's 1 and this is 2. So our number 1 is 2. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you have 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have 2-butene. You have 2-butene. Sorry. And you have another one which is known as the 1-butene. So both this 2-butene and 1-butene are called the position isomers of each other. So this is how, my dear students, we understand the position isomer. Bachcho, agar isme aapko kuch samajh mein nahi aaya to aap pooch sakte hain. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Dear students, do you have anything to ask? You can ask me.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, okay, very good. Thank you. In the okay, let's move forward and understand it a little better. Just 1 minute, my dear students. Okay, so let's move forward. Now, my dear students, we want to study more examples. We want to study about the more examples. Of position isomerism. Let us study them one by one, dear students. Suppose you have this compound CH3, C triple bond C and CH3, and you may have this compound CH3, CH2, C triple bond CH. So when you see the position of the triple bond, here you can see that the lowest position where the triple bond is available is on second position. But here if you look into this, you will realize that the lowest position where the triple bond is present is 1. And that is why we call this compound as 2-butyne. Whereas here we call it as a 1-butyne, and both these 2-butyne and 1-butyne are called the position isomers of each other. Same way, my dear students, if you look into the propanol, so we can have CH3, CH2, CH2OH, or we may have CH3CH, CH3OH. You can see that both these compounds have names. This is what it is known as 1-propanol. This is what it is known as 2-propanol. And both this 1-propanol as well as 2-propanol, they are known as the position isomers. Of each other. Now the next, my dear students, let us look at the example. For ketone, my dear students, you can see that you can have CH3CO, CH2CH3, and then my dear students, you may have CH3CH2CO, CH2CH2, and CH3. Here, if you look into the position, my dear students, you can see that the functional group CO is present on second carbon, and here you can see that the functional group is present on the third carbon, and thus we can write their names. This is what it is known as the 2-hexanone. This is what it is known as the 3-hexanone. And both these 2-hexanone and 3-hexanones are known as the position isomers of each other. So I hope, my dear students, you have understood it well. Do you have any doubt regarding this? You can ask me. Do you understand the position isomerism well, dear students? Hello, dear students, do you have any doubt?
No.
Let me give you one more example.
Yes.
Please remember, my dear students, that the compound number 1, see, this is what we call it 1, 2 and 3, and here we give the numbering this way. So we call it 1-aminopropane. Whereas this is 2-aminopropane. And please remember, my dear students, these both are the position isomers of each other. So this is how, my dear students, we can understand. Same way, if we have 1-nitropropane or 2-nitropropane, we can have 2-chloropropane or 1-chloropropane. So I hope, my dear students, now you have understood it. Let me give you a few more examples. Let me give you a few more examples, my dear students. We can have CH3CH2CH2CH2Cl, and we can have CH3CHCl, CH2CH3. So the name of this compound is 1-chlorobutane. This is 2-chlorobutane. And both these are the chain isomers, or sorry, position isomers of each other. We may have CH3CH2CH2NO2, or we may have CH3CH CH3NO2. So this is what it is known as, the 1-nitropropane. Let us put N capital, 1-nitropropane. And this is what it is known as, the 2-nitropropane. I hope, my dear students, now you have the very clear idea about the position isomers of each other. So they are the position isomers. Both this, one nitropropane and two nitropropane, they are also called the position isomers of each other. So now, my dear students, I think you have understood the position isomerism in a very clear manner. In the next period, my dear students, we will